are together again. And this morning we'll start with a little bit of just Brahma Vihara, a little metta, but with the Vipassana physical sensations today. Just for a little while, just bringing your attention to your hands. And just noticing with the pure Vipassana, just noticing any physical sensations that are coming and going by themselves. And with the talk on Vedana last night, the sense of just allowing, making space for any pleasant, unpleasant, and neutral feeling in the mind. So that when we bring kindness or care, quiet abiding with these sensations, we're connecting the awareness with the actual moment-to-moment experience. So the awareness starts to infuse those changing sensations with kindness, care. Or appreciation. So we're receiving the life of our body, the aliveness, the changing sensations that we might call hand or hands. So we're shifting out of the visual image. Our concept of hand. Drop into the experience without going through the thought process. And then as you receive the warmth or tingling, numbness, pressure, you notice if the attention can have a little care, a little kindness. Or not. It's okay if there isn't. If we have a numbness physically or in the mind, then you see if you can step back and care about that. Just numb. It's okay. Or any resistance in the mind. Just make space for that. Open up the attention. You see if you can shift to the movement of the breath at the abdomen for a bit. You can put your hand there that has already been connected with kindness. Often it's just a sense of touch that we're missing. So the touching of the abdomen and inviting that movement to just be just as it is. Or that area of our bodies to just be able to relax and be just as it is. No pressure. And if there's any agenda or expectation, just notice that it can come and go by itself. Kindness, care, the agenda or expectation. But knowing we don't have to buy into it. Noticing if the attention can be right with the movement as close as you can to when it's happening. But no forcing. If be careful if you're behind or ahead, just notice that. So we have to, the sense of exploration. With how things are, the nature, if something begins. Like the beginning of the breath, the rising. Its nature is to appear. Live itself out and disappear. So if we feel like we tighten around the breath, this movement at the abdomen, you can see how if your attention is in the hand, the attention doesn't have to be inside the abdomen. It can just be right on the surface. And the hand can be infused with compassion or metta. It can seep into the sensations of the breath or not. No problem. And if you feel disconnected, you can always put this hand infused with kindness on your heart center. Or if you don't need your hand, that's fine, but just finding the mind, finding the heart. It doesn't have to be intense in any way. It can be so close to neutral or neutral or sweet or just this quiet, abiding, quiet connection. And whatever is happening, sleepiness or boredom, kindness, peace, anger, grief, joy. Restlessness, sleepiness. Letting the heart mind be just as it is. Like the movement of the breath. Whatever is happening, appearing, living itself out and disappearing. Resistance, acceptance, lost here. You're just connecting with this quiet, abiding, and light kindness. With life just as it is, the nature of things just as they are. Seeing, hearing, smelling, tasting, touching, thinking, emotions. Quiet, abiding, with kindness. Or sometimes the kindness drops away. sometimes when you get up to stand right now and then to walk, remember we really emphasize the standing posture as well as the sitting and walking, so that the shifting from the sitting to the standing, you know, take your time with it. See if you can notice any physical sensations in your body as you're standing, or knowing the mind, being aware of the mind, knowing you're standing, and then turning. And there are many ways to walk. You know, you can be aware of the bottom of your feet. You can be aware of the sensations in your legs. You can be aware of, if you're moving slowly, sometimes just touching the wall as you walk, like a little bit, just keeping your balance that way, making contact with the walls in your house. Sometimes I keep it really simple and just am aware of knowing I'm walking. When I'm in between, like a formal to formal, like a formal sitting, formal walking, this just knowing walking. Sometimes I'm aware of knowing I'm walking in the bottom of my feet, knowing I'm walking in the bottom of my feet, that like a rhythm there. Often in the these practices that I've learned, particularly from Burma, there's often a rhythm of practice. So it could be that when you do some formal walking, if there's a lot of sound, you'd be aware of hearing. And then the bottom of your feet. You see, like there's a rhythm that can appear during each walking period. You get to know yourself on a self-retreat more deeply. There's a way in which sometimes some of us prefer sitting and don't do as much walking. Good to see, but that will mean that we'll nudge you a bit to do more walk, a little more walking. And if you like walking more than sitting, you know, you have more leisure to explore these things, but we'll nudge you to do a little bit more sitting. The sitting and walking is meant to balance us. We can't always see it day to day. Often we have more concentration in one or the other. So if you have more concentration sitting, you won't like the walking as much. If you have more concentration in walking, you won't like the sitting as much. But the design of this is that the place where the concentration isn't as strong, you have less control and more stuff comes up and the mind wanders more and we don't like it. And we think it's bad practice, but actually it's good practice. So be careful of judging the practice. It's like, it might feel like you're a mess, and actually that's great. That's really good practice. Just be very careful of the overlay of the judgment. It's a, as we're moving into the unfathomable practice time on the retreat. Unfathomable meaning there's no way you can know where you are. Thankfully, finally the figuring it out mind has to take a little rest, which is really exciting and wonderful. And don't forget to check for interviews if you haven't yet. They start at 10:15. And are there any announcements? No? Okay. I think I'd like to add one more thing for today, which I'm going to just stand up a little bit. In terms of the sense doors, the sixth sense door, the mind door, knowing, hearing, knowing anger, you know, knowing sadness, knowing joy, knowing kindness, knowing body sensations, etc. The knowing is much more sensitive. The heart center, that door, is more sensitive than the eyeball. It's so sensitive. if you can imagine how sensitive that mind door is that can pick up the speed of sound, the speed of light, speed of thought. It's very, the body sensations, it's like it's so unfathomable how sensitive that mind door is. And that's where pleasant, unpleasant, neutral are happening. And so if there's something painful, we tend to project it outside of us and blame or manipulate. But actually, or if there's something pleasant, you know, we get attached to it, we grab on to hold it. See, at times, if you're feeling off, try to bring your attention back there to the heart center and just let yourself know, oh, ouch, oh, holding on, oh, pushing away. It's just wanting, not wanting, and they're painful. The mind is so sensitive. We're just trying to protect ourselves from pleasure, pain, neutral, from the change. And it's just like allowing that, accepting that, making space for that. And then the contraction will just release itself by allowing the contraction around the change and the pain, the pleasure, neutral. It just will unwind itself if you give it a little space. So have a good day of practice.